The idea for today's video is brought to us by YouTube user Dalton Wood, who wants to see us mix iron powder into oobleck and then see if a magnet will cause that oobleck to harden up. Not too long ago, we showed you a DIY recipe for making some magnetic ooze, and it'll be interesting to see if the magnetic oobleck will get drawn into a magnet the same way the magnetic ooze does, or if the non-Newtonian fluid nature of the oobleck will cause it to just harden up in the presence of a magnet. The idea for this one is very simple. We're gonna mix up a batch of oobleck and then try mixing in some iron oxide, which is quite magnetic, to see if we can make magnetic oobleck. Will a magnet cause the oobleck to harden up the way pushing on it does, or will it stretch and reach the way magnetic putty will? As a first step, I think we need to mix ourselves up some oobleck. Here we go, we've got ourselves a batch of normal oobleck, which of course is just made from cornstarch and water mixed together, and this stuff is so freaking cool. I think everyone's played with this stuff. So now let's see if we can make this magnetic by adding some magnetite. This is a synthetic black iron oxide available online, and we're just gonna add a little bit of it and see how much we need to add to make it magnetic. Of course, we don't want to add too much because cornstarch and water is fairly specific. If you start adding too much of other liquids or solids, then it doesn't react in the same way. This whole bag, you can see, is quite attracted to a magnet. Get some of this very fine black powder out. I don't know how much of this we're going to need to make the oobleck magnetic. Let's start small and just keep adding from there. And mixing oobleck is always loads of fun because as soon as you start to mix it, it turns solid. You basically just break pieces off and fold them on top of each other and let it liquefy again. It looks like cookies and cream. Even with just that little bit, this feels a little bit more crumbly than it was before. It's still basically the same idea, but it's even more dry. Maybe we've just had a slight bit of evaporation, but I think we need to add a little bit more water. We've got our non-Newtonian fluid with some of our magnetite mixed in, but the question is if we have enough for it to really be magnetic. It's not even black yet, it's a dark gray, but in the past, before we got something really to respond to a magnet, we had enough magnetite in it to turn it black. So I'm gonna try adding just a little bit more. We've got our blackened magnetite-filled oobleck, and now I think it's time to test whether or not this stuff is magnetic, and if it is, what happens when you bring a magnet near it? I'm starting off with a pretty darn powerful magnet just because I really want to see what happens in the presence of something that's really going to pull on this. So I'm going to start by just putting it on the outside of the bowl. Let's see what it does on the inside. You can see it is gathering a little bit. It's moved over to the side. It's not pulling on it very strongly though, or if it is, then it's solidifying up so we can't see it pulling much. Let's just bring it right next to the magnet and really see what happens here. Oh, it's certainly pulling on it, and that's looking quite a bit like how it reacts to the magnetic ooze, but I think it is actually keeping it from turning back into a liquid. It's constantly pulling on it enough. You can see with just this little blob, if I stop moving, it starts running and just kind of pouring down my finger a little bit. The magnetite, this black dust, has a tendency to stain very quickly and easily. I'm going without gloves because I want you to be able to see it really nicely, but I don't know, it might just turn my fingers black pretty quick. So you can see as long as I keep this rolling around, it's fairly solid, and then as soon as I stop, it just puddles, turns into a liquid. It's not quite as runny as it is when it's normal oobleck without magnetite powder in it, but the same thing is working. So now let's see what happens on the magnet again. Put it on the magnet. And it does seem to be holding it still. It's not running off the way it was in my fingers. Let's grab another little blob about the same size. So my fingers, if I stop doing anything with it, you see it begins to run. But the stuff on the magnet is being held in place. It's staying fairly solid. In fact, I can even poke it and feel that it feels fairly solid. But when I have strands dripping down, it really does pull on it in a similar manner to our magnetic ooze. Here I've got a batch of the same magnetic slime that we mixed up previously, and this is our newly made magnetic oobleck. Let's look at the differences between how these react. So magnetic slime, magnet, see it starts pulling it pretty well. Very stretchy stuff. As a comparison, our magnetic oobleck. it does start to move very quickly. It moves into where the magnet is pulling on it. But at that point, it doesn't pull and stretch the way our magnetic slime does. Getting a little bit of it. I have to hold the magnet closer, move it around a bit, and it's definitely slower, but we are getting some stretch out of our oobleck. So definitely a very different type of stretching than we see with our magnetic ooze. So our two giant magnets inside of our two magnetic semi-fluids do behave differently. This one over here is the slime, and we were able to see that that slime very quickly reached up and grabbed all the way around the magnet, surrounding it, engulfing it, and it is just completely suspended in the magnetic slime right now. The magnetic oobleck, it did some similar things, but it didn't do nearly as much as the slime did. As the magnet started pulling it together, I believe it did start hardening the oobleck the same way as when you play with it or roll it around or poke it really hard. And because of that, not too much of the substance was able to start climbing up around the magnet. But I did find that when I started taking the bowl and vibrating it, it sort of made the oobleck enter this state of liquefaction where it became more runny, and suddenly it began climbing up the sides of the magnet a lot faster. It was also fun because the whole magnet started sliding toward the other magnet. They're about 8 inches apart and they're starting to pull each other. So the magnetic oobleck does definitely harden up. The magnet powder in there not only changes the consistency of the oobleck a little bit, but it also makes it react to a magnet, and it seizes up and becomes a lot more hard and durable. And in fact, just poking this spot over here feels a lot softer than the part that's touching the magnet itself. I also thought it was fun, as I was moving the bowls, I noticed that the magnets like to stay pointed towards each other, so if I turn the magnet in the slime, my magnet starts just rotating, dragging all of the slime with it. Another interesting thing happening right now is that the magnet is pulling on some of the oobleck with magnetite powder, and it's so hard that it's actually squeezing some of the water out of it. This is a similar issue to what we ran into when we were trying to make magnetic fluid, a ferrofluid. And it's that a lot of the time the magnet is so strong, it squeezes the particulate together so hard that the water doesn't have space in between the little particles, and it just starts dripping out. Dalton Wood, you wanted to know whether or not we could add iron powder and make magnetic oobleck. The answer is mostly we can. It does change the consistency, so it's not quite the same as normal oobleck, but it does still form a ball when you play with it and puddle out when you stop moving it around. It's not quite as firm or quite as liquid either side, but it is still a non-Newtonian fluid, and it does get pulled by a magnet, and yes, the pull of the magnet does cause it to harden. So, good question. Fun experiment to try. Thank you for your suggestion. Check your YouTube inbox, Dalton. We're gonna be sending you 25 bucks. Guys, it's not over. We've got more for you to see. That box up at the top will transport you directly to our last video, and you should go check that out. The box at the bottom will show you what YouTube thinks you need to be watching next. And this bomb here in the middle will subscribe you to the channel. That way you never miss a video. Don't forget to ring that bell, and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then.